Okay, time for another car review from GT6. This time out, it's the new C7 series Corvette. I've always had a soft spot for the Vette, but with the C7, Chevy really got the formula back. Running 575 brake horsepower at 1,230 kilos for a PP rating of 600, and as usual, the car is on sports soft tyres. Starting at Sierra's SS2 stage, the Vette launched offline, shredding its rear tyres right in the second gear. Damn, US Muscle can be really angry sometimes. It kicks its backside out straight away into turn 1, but seems pretty panicked by the next corner. I did have to lift a little through the sharp bend just before you descend at the one section before the first straight, but the C7 is so panicked through the curbs, it's okay as it holds around 150 before reaching 170 just at the start of the straight. That new 7-speed box really helps it charge on at 187 mph just before you absolutely have to brake for the hairpin at the end. Car likes a little squirm here and there, but I have to say, this is the most agile American car I've ever dealt with. You still have to back off going over the hill just after the two crests, but it's not too much. Through the long sweeper, the Vette Grassy picks at around 100 mph and then charges out as you put your foot flat. Doesn't do too bad over the jump either, and then holds a ton again, turning at the tight right-hander just after the bridge. Slides sweetly around the hairpin left, showing how easily it will throw the tail out. Going in the uphill section and through the tight right-hander, it's not bad at all, and then charges through the last section with ease, running a time of 2 minutes 26 seconds. Just goes to show the development effort Chevy have gone with this C7 model. Let's see how the Vette deals with Sierra's SS3. Again, it shreds the tires on launch, but it is US muscle, so that's kind of expected after all. But through the first and second hairpin, you wouldn't think it was a muscle car. C7 just flicks its tail out and powers out perfectly. Through the two 90 degree bends at the top of the hill, Stingray continues to surprise, being more agile and smooth than a lot of other cars are there. Right, now to a long fast set of sweepers. Again, the C7 shines from 150 to 160 mph. Bearing in mind, this is on road tires, where in a lot of other cars, a lot of European cars, you would have to back off. Apart from being a little bit twitchy, this thing has phenomenal levels of grip. After a nice slide at the hairpin, just at the end, and then again just after the short straight, going round and into the fast cone section for that last bit. Just kicks its tail out so easily, almost just lazily drifting around. Holds 70 through the tight left hander just after the bridge, and like in the old Japanese saying, Corvette flows like water for the last few cars and crosses the line in 2 minutes 25. Good car, seriously good car. And I have to say, well done Chevrolet, that's a massive step on from the last bit. It wasn't too bad. I didn't see where it's getting that time around the Nürburgring. Tokyo. Small city. Big America. Could be tricky, but you never know. The C7 hits a buck 76 before having a brake for the first turn. Being rear wheel drive certainly helps as you watch the acceleration on the exit, and it ain't too bad if you continue on through the quick left right flick just after. It's a lot less flinchy than our cars, smoothly holds 85 around the long 108 degree turn. Sharp left then just after that, Vic kicks its tail out as you plant it up just after the apex, and then head on down to the next turn, just as you pass 120 miles an hour. Two 90 degree turns go well, with a little slide through both of them, setting up nicely for the downhill section, which usually I find just a bit too narrow, but the C7 seems to slip through quite the thing. They really have worked wonders on this one. It really does seem built for twisty roads and circuit use. After hitting 170 again on the straight, crossed the line in a minute and 44 seconds. Last but not least, Goodwood. The Vet should really shine on track, so let's see how it gets on. Usual tyre squeal off the line, but seems to settle down well into the first two turns, before charging under the bridge at 120 miles an hour. C7 takes a sharp left smoothly and good pace, and is much the same at the flick just as you can pass the front wall after the short straight. Corvette really does well here again, big car soaking up the twisties. After diving through the last couple of turns, clocked a 47 second run. All I can say overall is, wow, well done Chevy, I have to applaud you on that car. Seriously, well rounded. Monster. Cheers for watching guys, peace.